You don't want to have any tray discrepancies. That's what it's called when your tray is short. That is what happens when your till doesn't have the same exact money that the system in the back says that it's supposed to have. It's called a tray discrepancy. And you can get written up for this. You can possibly get fired for this, but not right off the bat. All these things are really, really essential in order to make sure your tray isn't coming up short or over. Okay, so I'm gonna teach you guys today what to do, tips and tricks to avoid this. So make sure you keep on watching. Before we get started, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and let's get into it. Hey guys, welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'm going to be teaching you guys how to avoid tray discrepancies. I explained it in the beginning. What is a tray discrepancy? It's basically when you come out short or over the amount of money that your tray is supposed to have. This often happens because you gave the wrong amount of change to someone. You gave them too much or too little. And despite whichever one it is, I know sometimes we think, oh, well, I'd rather have more money in my tray than less money. Publix doesn't see it like that. Publix sees it as you're stealing from the customer, and it's still a write-up. It's still you're in trouble. It's still a mistake, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and get into it and teach you guys how to avoid this because I wanna help you guys. If you guys haven't caught up with my Publix playlist, make sure you guys go to my playlist and start watching some of these Publix videos because I've helped over hundreds of people get hired. I want to help you guys do good and ensure your success in this company or anywhere else because a cashier can be found anywhere. I did recently do a video where I basically spoke on what do you do as a cashier on a register, like how does the register work, how does the till work. So if you haven't checked that out, I'll leave the link at the end of this video, and I feel like that one was super helpful. But in this video, I'm going to be covering what to do if you're still coming out short. Now, you want to make sure that you're counting your money 2 and 3 times, okay? That is number one, to be relaxed, to be counting your money, stuff like that. Now, I'm assuming if you're having tray discrepancies, you've been in the company for a while, you know how to run the register. So the managers are allowing you to manage this register by yourself. So at this point, you should kind of know what you're doing, because if you don't, then you definitely need to catch up or speak to someone so that they can help you. But if you keep coming up short, first of all, you need to evaluate how you're ringing up these customers. Are you counting your money 2 and 3 times? Are you comparing the receipt with what the register says to make sure it's the same amount? Are you giving the person the right amount of change? All these things are really, really essential in order to make sure your tray isn't coming up short or over. Now, a lot of times you're not the only one on that tray. There's people before you who are on that tray and after you. And I've seen this happen though, where managers sometimes just blame you and you're like, hold up, there were 2 other people using this tray. So how do you know it was me? Now, I know there's sometimes ways to track it in the system, as into like the time where the discrepancy happened, but not all the time can they track that because cash is almost like an untrackable thing. So you want to make sure you keep track of the money in your tray. Now, I personally, the way I would do this, now, I know Publix doesn't really do this or have their cashiers do this, but if you're coming up short or over too often, then I would say to suggest this or to just do this in order to see where you're going wrong. I don't personally do this because I don't really go short or over. I have in the past though, once, and I think it was a mistake because I was honestly in the bathroom when the discrepancy happened, but it was under my PIN number, so I got blamed for it obviously, which is fine. I took the responsibility, I had to sign, whatever. If you're short once or twice, you're not getting fired, relax. You know, all these managers have gotten written up at one point or another, so you're not the only one. You didn't commit this huge bad thing. Like, you know, yes, it's bad, but it's not like, oh my gosh, bad, you know? Especially if it's like a short amount of money. Publix does give you a little leeway where like if it's a $10 or something like that difference, you know, you're not gonna get written up. You know, it's common for us to lose a little bit of money, whatever. But you still don't want that. I always try for my tray to honestly be like perfect, okay? Because that's just the best way to avoid problems, okay? So the best way I would say to do this, if you're constantly coming up short or over, which I had a friend who personally, this was happening to him, and we were all like, bro, like, are you not counting the money? Like, Are you getting confused with the change versus what you're receiving? Like, what is it that you're confused in? And he didn't even know. So, like, if you're genuinely confused with something and that's why you feel like your tray is coming short or over, then speak up, because if not, you're just going to keep getting in trouble and you can get fired because of this, you know? But I know some of you guys are like, has this ever happened to you guys? And yes, it has. I'm not perfect. Yes, it's happened to me. I've come up short. I was freaking out because I felt like it wasn't me. And sure enough, I don't think it was, but I mean, if it's under your number, then you are at fault. So I just had to, you know, accept it and go and whatever. And I'm still in the company and I'm still succeeding and thriving and everything. So you'll be fine if you are, or if you have come up short or over, okay? Now, honestly, like I was telling you guys, there's different people who use your tray besides you. So the best way to do it is before you use a tray, to count it. In customer service, this is how we do it because I feel like we deal with a lot more money, so it's like mandatory that we do it over there. But cashiers usually don't have to do it because I guess it's less money. But like I said, if you just know that you're having this problem, then just handle it the same way customer service would. When we get our tills, when we get into our register, there was obviously somebody before us using our till or our register, right? The shift before us was using it. So when I come in for my shift, there's already been a few hands on this register and till. I'm not accountable for that money that if they lost or if they're over or whatever the situation is, I'm not accountable. I wasn't here. I didn't put my hand in there. So when I get to work, I count my till. I print out the till report and I count my till and I make sure both of the numbers match. So if my till report says I'm supposed to have $100 in my tray and my tray only has $90, I put accountable whoever was using my tray, verified by me. So that means that whoever was counting or whoever was here before me is missing $10. So if my shift ends and my tray is still $10 short, that's not on me. So that's basically what I'm telling you guys to do. And this is just protocol in customer service. That's not just me trying to be stingy. I think it's the right way to do things, but that's not just like my decision. This is definitely like what customer service has you do. You have to record, you know, before you come in your shift and after you end your shift to see where the discrepancies went wrong so that you're not blamed for something you didn't do. So the way Publix has us do it is that at the end of our shift, so when I finish my shift, I counted it when I first got there, okay? If I was supposed to have $100 and I had $90, at the end of my shift, I got to count it again. So if at the end of my shift, I have $50 and the till report says it's still supposed to have $100, I mean, I lost $40 because if my till was supposed to have $100 and I start off my shift with only $90 because the girl in front of me lost $10, but I end my shift with $50, these $40, that's on me. I lost $40 and the girl before me lost $10, essentially creating that my till only has $50. Now, if my shift ends and I only have $90, I'm perfect. I'm fine. My till's supposed to have $100 and I only have $90, but I had that $90 since I first got in that shift. So that's not my fault. That was the person in front of me fault, or the person who had the shift before me fault. So if you're having this many discrepancies with your tray and you feel like it's not you, if you're like, bro, I'm doing everything right, count your tray when you first get there and count your tray when you leave and compare it to the till report, so that they can't tell you it's you if you genuinely feel like it's not you. Now you might count it and realize that it is you. And if it is you, then you need to figure out what it is that you're doing wrong. Are you distracted? Are you not going to work comfortable? Are you paying attention to little things? Are you hungry? Are you like, dang, I'm so hungry here. Here's a $10 and by accident you're giving them a $20 bill. Are you re-verifying your bills? Are you comparing it to the receipt? Like, you got to think about it. The registers do all the math for you. You're not doing math. You're just counting. So when somebody gives you money, count it 2 and 3 times. Do not care if the customer is like, you're taking long. All right. They could go to a different line because it's going to be worse if you're coming out with $30, $40 short every night. Okay. You can get written up. If you get written up 3 times, you can get suspended or fired and stuff like that. So I would definitely say that's just like a huge tip of mine. So take that into consideration. If you guys have any other suggestions of videos you want to do, any questions that you guys have for me, go ahead and leave it down in the comment section below. I will be answering all my comments and I appreciate you guys. And with that being said, I'm just going to end this video because I feel like I answered that question in depth. So if you guys have anything else you guys want me to address, let me know. But other than that, I'll see you guys in my next video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you guys, like always, for supporting me and coming with me on this journey. I'm very excited and want to see all of you guys succeed despite whatever company it is. So whether you're short or over in Winn-Dixie, Walmart, Target, wherever it is, follow these tips because it should help you out. And other than that, I'll see you guys in my next video. Thanks so much for watching and don't forget to subscribe. Bye.